why that you chose nursing or medical assisting or whatever position that you may have. We'll go through the slides and then we'll have a little bit of an interaction with it, not a lot, because I know a lot of people do not like interaction, but we'll try a few. Okay, so for before the interview, you want to make sure that you want to research us. Go out on our website and just exactly what is Meadowview? Who do we hire? What kind of positions do we have? Wherever, and I'm just going to use Meadowview for an example. But whatever company, if you go to Toyota and say, you know, what do we, do you see? Okay. Go to Toyota, find out what their background is. What type of people are they looking for? We're back on the air. Review the job description. When you go in to interview for a position, just ask them, say, may I have a job description so that way that I would, thank you so much, so I will know exactly what this job is entailed. And you want to make sure that it will match your experience and your education. So when you go into an interview, for example, you want to go in and I may ask you, so tell me, why did you choose Meadowview as one of your employers that you would like to work for? So you want to be able to tell me, well, I want to, I want to be able to become the best nurse that you have. I know that you are going to be one of the 100 top hospitals. I know that I have done my clinicals here, and so forth and so on, and this is what I experienced. So those are some things that that you could talk about. You want to talk about, there's one of the questions that we always start out with is, tell me about yourself. Be prepared. Tell me about yourself. What do you like to do? It doesn't have to be, you know, well, I have a 4.0 and so forth. Tell us just about yourself. What do you like to do? What type of jobs do you like to do? And so forth. Is there any questions so far? Okay. Make sure that you have the appropriate interview attire. It's just whatever we're wearing. Right there. Make sure that when you interview, a couple of things. For the gentleman, if possible, wear a suit and tie. Not necessarily. Be business casual. Wear khakis, a nice shirt, button-up, polo. Well-groomed. Make sure that those are the types of attire that you would wear. Belt, shoes, don't come in flip-flops. You'd be surprised at the interviews. People will come in a pair of blue jeans and flip-flops. That is a strike immediately. If it says avoid ties with elaborate patterns or too many colors, if you prefer to wear a tie, if you're going for like a management position, I would suggest that you wear not a three-piece, but just maybe a khaki, a nice shirt, a tie, and a jacket. Head to toe, hair should be well groomed and shoes should be polished. So let's look at this next one here. Who would you hire? Which one of those would you hire? If this one right here came in. If this one here on the right came in, would you hire him? Why? Why would you hire him? He's got a shirt on. Looks like his hair. Why would you hire him?
Well, it's disrespectful.
It is disrespectful, isn't it? And what about the one on the left? I would rather hire the one on the left than I would on the right, because why?
Well,
that's right. That's right. He's taken time to groom himself. This one looks like he just got out of bed. And it's just like, okay, this here on the right, if he walked in, my perception of him would be, you owe me a job. And he would flop down in a chair, he would not sit up straight, and he would just slouch. That's what this person would be to me. Am I wrong? Okay. So let's talk a little bit about the ladies now, since we picked on the men. A suit or a dress is preferred. You can just be groomed again. Make sure your hair is fixed, you know, however you want to say. Skirts should be at least to the knee. Don't go to a interview with a short mini skirt on and high heels about this tall. Don't do that. The amount of jewelry should be minimized. Don't go in with a lot of jewelry on. Just, you know, a pair of earrings, a nice necklace, and a ring or two. But don't come in with all kinds of rings on and jewelry all the way up to here and necklaces everywhere. That's too much. Makeup should be very light. You don't want to come in with green fingernails and lots of makeup on your eyes, bright red lipstick, and false eyelashes out to here. I mean, you want to look presentable. Okay? Any questions? And perfumes? A lot of times people are actually allergic to perfumes. So you want to wear those lightly. So let's look at her. What about her? Would you hire her? Mm-hmm. All right, man, no. Would you hire that girl, or would you hire her? First one? Second.
Second.
So why would you hire her?
She looks slutty.
Tree parts. That's right. You know, here she is in a short top. Stomach is midriff area is showing, blue jeans. She just walks in like, I don't care. That's the perception that you get when they walk in. I don't care. So you've got her, and then you've got him. So both of those are the type, if they walked into an office, it would be, you owe me a job, I don't care if I get it or not. So that's why you want to make sure that you are groomed and ready for an interview. See, she has a notebook with her, and when she would walk in with a notebook, okay, you know what that tells me? Number one, she's going to ask me questions at the end. It's not just going to be me asking her. She's going to ask me questions, so I have to be prepared as well as an interviewer. Also, it looks like to me that she probably has an extra... she is probably has an extra resume. And what she's going to do when she sits down is, if you do not have a resume, here is my resume. So that would be something that you would do, is that when you sit down, I'm a visual person, I don't know about you. So if you sit down, first thing you want to do is that you want to go over and you say, hi, I'm Diana Kennedy. A firm shake, not a little wimpy one. You want a firm shake like, you're going to hire me and I want this job. Then when she sits down, she's going to sit down like this, and that's how. You don't want to sit down like this, you sit down like this, okay? So now my interview has started, so then I would say, in case you do not have a resume, here is my resume for your review. And then she knows, first thing I'm thinking of, she's organized. So those are just a few little things that you can just kind of think of. Any questions? Don't be late. You want me to tell you what you think about when someone's late? Number one, again, they don't care if they get the job or not. Number two, they're going to be late all the time. And 9 times out of 10, that happens. I did an interview one time, and they were about 5 or 10 minutes late. So we went ahead and done the interview with them. We do peer interviews. So a question I asked was, what is one of your weaknesses that you have? And you want me to tell you what they said? I can't be to work on time. That's what they said. I cannot be to work on time. And I looked at my watch and I said, you're right. You were 10 minutes late. So see, that's what our perception is that if you are not there on time for your interview, if you're not to work on time, or to your interview on time, then you're only working on time. You have no respect. It goes right back to that person that we see, that whoever, who was it that said they had no respect? You did? Said that they didn't have any respect. That's true. Greet the interviewer with that firm handshake, just like I did. Maintain a good eye and posture when you do it. And make sure that you're energetic and enthusiastic. If I would say, tell me about yourself. Well, I like to go to work sometimes if I can. because, and then that's when you fall back on, tell me about yourself. Give them your strong points, not your weak points. That's in the later. Your strong points, why you are going to be a good employee. I'm intelligent at my skills. I know how to be a nurse. I don't, but let's say I was a nurse. My skills tell me that I know how to take care of patients. I give quality patient care. I'm very well organized. When I had my evaluation on charting, it was 100%. You see what I mean? You're positive. And you want to use the I word because you are the one that we are interviewing. Any questions? Okay. Now don't be afraid. Okay, here are some, I'm going to give you these, and I made these copies for you, and I want you to take them. They're for you. Thank you. These are just some questions that sometimes that interviewers will ask. And on the first one that we have, it kind of tells you about, it asks you the question, but then it kind of tells you the reason why we ask you and what we're looking for. And if you've got a pencil and paper, and I'll tell you what else you can do, you can go out on Google and you can type in. Tell me how to make this stop.
Is it PowerPoint?
Yes, but it's not supposed to.
It's on a timer.
It must be.
Can somebody change the timer to stop to PowerPoint? I can't remember.
Yeah, I have a stop. There you go. Thank you so much. You can go out and Google, and let's say what you can say is interview skills or interview questions for RNs or interview questions for management positions. Google those, and it will tell you exactly how to prepare yourself. It will tell you exactly how, this is where I got this at. Just to give you an example, I went out on Google, and that's how I got this PowerPoint. There's tons and tons of information out there that you can get.
It's supposed to be after that. Try it out. Change the direction. Well, it's on me. Just something else.
That's okay. Hopefully it's almost done.
Hopefully it's on me. Did everybody get one of those things and papers? Do you have any extras?
Okay. These questions, some of them are on there, some of them are not. Some of them are redundant on those pages, but it just kind of depends on what kind of interview you're going to. First question, what was it I told you? The first thing I'm going to ask you, tell me about yourself. And how are you going to answer it? With enthusiastic on the reasons why I want to work for you and why you should hire me. What's your greatest strength? What do you do well? That's what you want to focus on. Your weaknesses? Everybody has a weakness. Everybody does. Don't go to the interview and say, I don't have any. We all have a weakness. So if you have to think of it before you go, think of a weakness. A weakness would be, I'm OCD, I'm too well organized, or if a picture is crooked, it drives me crazy, or a rug, or something, you know, that's a weakness, because sometimes that kind of stuff drives people crazy if you go in their office and start straightening up their pictures. I do. I do. Sometimes I went to my CFO's office, I said, you've got to do something with that picture, it's crooked. But see, that's a weakness that I have, but we just all laugh about it. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? You know how whenever you're in management and other corporations, sometimes you have to have a five-year plan? In order to be successful, you need a five-year plan. Where do you want to be at in 5 years? Let's say you started out as in manufacturing. Let's do manufacturing. How many of you want to interview for a manufacturing? Let's say, but it's a busy. And they hire you on the entry level. Well, if they ask you, where do you want to be at in 5 years? I want to be a supervisor. That's what I want to do. Well, why do you want to be a supervisor? Because I'm well organized and I feel like I could be a very good leadership if I had the training. what I want to do. I want to train. I want to train for a leadership position. Then that tells me, number one, they want the education. Number two, they do have a five-year plan. Number three is that they have got the enthusiastic and the gumption to be a good employee. What's your thoughts? You, what's your thoughts? Do you feel that way? That's right, you do. You want somebody that is going to be able to bring your company to the next level. Because face it, not everybody stays at a company forever. So you want to be able to take that place to someone else. What about this position do you find appealing? What does that fall back on? Your homework. Your homework about the company. The homework on why did you choose that facility or that business to interview. Why do you want to work for a company? Again, you did your homework. This is the reason why. And why should I hire you? Because, then go back to your strength question. That's why we would want to hire you. Any questions on that or any thoughts? Okay. We do a lot of behavior-based questions, and it's not a yes or no. One of them is that can you describe the most valuable criticism you have received, and what did you do with it? So what it's saying is that in another position that you have held, if you had a constructive criticism, how did you take it? Or can you tell me about an event that really challenged you? Sure, I can tell you about an event that really challenged me. I was given the opportunity to, and then think of a strength that you have done. Make sense? Okay. Can you give me an example of a project that required attention to detail and how you can handle the details? You know what? That's funny that you asked. I just finished a project and they had asked me to be over a project manager over whatever. So I can't hardly tell you what you're doing because I don't know what you're going to be interviewing for, but just think of a strength of something that would challenge you or something that you had done. For example, let's do a food chain. If you were challenged to do something, well, you know what? My supervisor was gone. The regional director called me and said, you've got to get the FTEs down, which is your full-time equivalent of people, down 3%. Well, I thought, okay, I can do that. That shows that you have analytical and critical thinking skills. Does that make sense? Okay. Can you tell me about a time you had a difficult person with whom you have worked with? Yes, I have. But, you know, with my conflict resolution training that I have had, we work it all out. That's how you handle that. Can you describe the supervisor that you have that you like the least? Think about it, you know, what would that be? And be honest about it. You know, not just say, well, we didn't get along, or, you know, I didn't like this and I didn't like that. Be constructive with it. Why did you not? I like to be able to take projects on my own, but they kind of micromanage me because I'm a go-getter. Does that make sense? Now, remember I told you that the girl had the book and she was prepared and she came? So, tell me, what kind of training am I going to have? Then it's my responsibility to tell you that, well, number one is that when you come in, you will be signing a job description and then we'll go over that with you. But we take it a step further and we have a department orientation checklist because we want to make sure that you are trained and oriented to that department. That's how I would answer you back. What type of advancement opportunities are available with your organization? We have all kinds of in our organization, the sky's the limit. You tell me then I would turn around and say, well, what type of a position are you looking for? What type of training would you like to have? That's what we would want to do for our employees. Make sense? Well, what is the timetable for your remainder of the hiring process? We will have our decision made within the next 2 weeks, and then you will receive a notification letting you know if you've been hired for the position or not. So those are some questions that you can come back with them at. And again, you can Google that. You can Google it online on questions to ask an employer. Ask the questions that demonstrate that you know that company. Well, I'm going to be an RN. I'm graduating in 2016, let's say. And I want to make sure that I really do want to work for your company, but I want to make sure that I'm able to take care of those patients and give that top quality care. So what type of a training would I get in that department orientation checklist? So you have to think about what the interviewer is telling you. Take notes. So then that way you can come back with more questions. Okay? Be sure to send a thank you. I have, after interviews, it doesn't have to be, it can be handwritten, but I have a lot that will just send me a note through email. They'll just say, you know, thank you for giving me the opportunity to interview for your company. I hope to hear from you soon. That's all you have to say. And keep hitting the P here. If you feel that you have poor handwriting, again, you can type a letter or you can just send an email. It's just as well. Guess what? That's the end of it. And so, who wants to be someone who wants to interact with me for a few minutes? I think I've got a few minutes before I have to run to the conference call. Oh, I do. Who wants to be? Who wants to do it? Want to do it? Come on then. Did you get volunteered? All right. So what we're going to do is that we're going to kind of demonstrate exactly. See, she won't be the only one. We'll have to get somebody else. Okay. So here is. We got to get this way up so we can see. Okay. So what she's going to do? You will be the interviewer. No, you will be the interviewer. You will come in and interview. Okay. So she's going to come in and walk through the door, and when she walks through the door, what's the first thing she's going to do?
Shake
my hand. So then you're going to come in and introduce yourself.
Christy.
This is Christy. So what she would do is, hi, my name is Christy. It's nice to meet you. Then you have a seat. So now she has her book. So we are going to sit down. I have sat down and I have met with her now. And now what's the second thing she's going to do? Offer me her resume. Now she's offered me the resume, and you say, if you do not have a copy of my resume, I have brought another copy for you. And then I read over it, and then that's when we start with the questions. So at the end of it, we both stand up. We shake hands again. Thank you. It's nice meeting you, and we'll hear from you in a couple of weeks. That's it. So that's, thank you so much. That is how you would go in for an interview. And then when you go in for an interview, if you're nervous, what they taught me is just put your hands here on your lap and then just do this, because they're not going to see you. You know, if you put your hands up on the desk, that means that you're trying to push me away. You don't want to see me. So just put your hands in your lap. And then if you need to tap your foot, you can put your hands like this. And what I'm doing is this right here. And then you just do that on your, like this. Okay? Now, if you're doing a peer interview with several, a lot of companies do the peer interview. We do. We have like six that's in our panel. They will ask you all these questions that you will see in this packet. Depends upon which you're going to talk to different ones. Because of what we have is that when I'm, for example, I'm hiring for an HR assistant. I have three directors. I have one from IT. I have one that would be another non-clinical. And then I have two or three others that are just in the hospital. And they're all sitting around the table just like you are. And you're sitting in front of them, like this was the panel. You would be sitting right here, and this panel would be telling us, asking me questions. Yes?
Now, would you walk in and shake all six people's hands? Mm-hmm.
You just start down here. Hi, my name is Diane. Nice to meet you. Your name is?
Charles.
Hi. and yours, Diana, nice to meet you. And then you go on down the line, just like that. You don't have to say, hi, my name is Diane, because they've already heard that. So that's my job, is your name is, and your name is, and then you go on down. And then that way, whenever you start interviewing, say, yes, Charles. You see what I mean? Yes, Charles, I do want to work for this company. Because then that's going to tell me, huh, they have a memory of trying to remember the name. Confidence. You've got to have confidence. So if you know the company, go in with confidence, it'll all come natural, promise you. I promise you it will. Okay? Take a look at those interview questions. Take them home with you. They're yours. Practice with yourself in front of a mirror. I did. And then that's you're your own critic. When you're looking at yourself in the mirror, you're your own critic. Like, oh, that expression didn't look right, you know. See what I mean? Videotape yourself. Yes. Everybody has a phone now. You can videotape yourself. I had to do an interview one time, and I thought, I'm just going to tape it, and I asked if I could tape it. I listened to myself, and I said, you've got to be kidding me. I was so embarrassed with myself, I said, you've got to be kidding me. I said the word, one word twice, and don't remember it. So you're your own critic, okay? Is there any questions or anything else that I can tell you about interviewing? Because I know that I don't want to bore you, but yet I want to make sure that you understand. Because I hope that all of you, if you're interviewing for a job, I hope all of you get a job. I really do. But interviewing is the number one, is the key. They can make a perception of you within 10 seconds when you walk in the room. They can also, did you know that the faster you walk, shows your energy? So if they take you a tour and you're just kind of walking like this, what's that say? I'm lazy. A firm handshake means what?
Confidence.
Standing straight up with a posture means what? Confidence. Eye contact means what? I'm not afraid to talk to you. I'm ready for any question that you want to ask me. Okay? I appreciate all of your time. If there's any questions or anything else I can do to help you, I'm sure they can get in touch with Angie. Is there anything? Does anybody have any questions that maybe I didn't cover? Yes.
On a resume, do you have to have a cover sheet?
You know, having a cover sheet is actually telling me why you want a job. And it's more professional. And you know, a lot of people feel like they have to, see what I mean? Have to have a 6-page resume. No. To be honest with you, I get bored looking at a 6-page resume. You should be able to tell me about yourself in 2 pages or less. I mean, don't be a bluff and, you know, just be very bullet point. But within 2 pages or less and a cover sheet, you should be able to tell me about yourself. Did you have a question?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, so I'm going for welding, and I'll be getting all these certificates.
Okay.
And when I go for an interview, should I bring those certificates?
Absolutely. And then how you would do that is that when you would come to me, mm-hmm. and I was interviewing you, put that with your resume, and then say, oh, by the way, just in case you didn't know, I have these certificates, and name them, mm-hmm. and show it to them.
So would a three-ring binder kind of?
You don't have to do a three-ring binder. You know, just the little soft that you can kind of slide your papers in is good enough. Three-ring binders means too much to me as a school. Mm-hmm. You don't even have to put them in a binder. Oh, not a binder, but the little soft binder. You don't have to do that. It's professional looking, mm-hmm. but you don't have to. But I would have them readily available. Because a lot of times, another thing, if you have to have a certification for welding and you know your license, if you would go ahead and present that certificate and that license to that employer, that's one thing they don't have to do, is ask you for that whenever you come. They already know that you have it. that make sense?
Yeah.
Good questions. Anybody else that's going to an interview or something that maybe I can help you with? You don't have to be shy. I know some people aren't shy. Okay. All righty. Angie, I guess I'm done. I hope that you learned something.
Yep.
I didn't do it for an hour.